Mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Richard Wood with Z News.
Welcome back, my friends. We will be live here with you for at least the next 30 minutes. It is Sunday, the third day of July 2011. If you're hearing this transmission, you are the resistance. Thank you for joining us for this, the 160th podcast edition of Z News, which is a compendium of information on business, finance, economics and social and political issues worldwide, reaching over 10,000 subscribers every Wednesday and Saturday. Parts of this publication are picked up by 60 different websites weekly, exposing our ideas to over 10 million investors a week. This show is devoted to serving the needs of those of you who get it and want to get through it. And if you're wondering if this is your cup of tea, thanks for stopping by and may your continued surfing be safe and satisfying. But for those that are looking for information, you're in good company, and I know you're in one of two places. You are well along in awareness and in the middle of preparation and planning, or you are on your way to getting there. Coming up on the show today, the United States will sell 30 million barrels from its Strategic Petroleum Reserve over the next 30 days. Canadians' confidence in the country's economic prospects fell to its lowest in 2 years amid concern that the global recovery is stalling. And the gauge of default swaps tied to Greece climbed 23 basis points, signaling an 84% probability of default within 5 years. Firstly today, to gold, silver and commodities news. Gold open interest rose 3,456 contracts to 510,338, as silver open interest rose 674 to 120,512. The HUI fell 0.22 and the XAU rose 0.28. We are near or on the bottom. Consumer spending gained only 0.1% in May, following April's 0.3% gain. After inflation adjustment, spending fell 0.1%. Spending on durable goods fell 1.5% after being flat in April. S&P believes a downgrade of US debt from AAA to AA or A cost $100 billion. The losses we believe will be much larger. As we predicted, the Fed will buy $300 billion more in treasuries, putting the total at $900 billion in September. $112.1 billion of the Fed's government bond holdings mature in the next year, 7% of Treasuries worth $1.59 trillion. It holds $914.4 billion of credit default swaps and mortgage-backed securities toxic waste, and $118.4 billion in debentures. The Greek banking system is in trouble, having lost 8% of deposits. Most of those funds have been invested in gold coins. If the figure were to go to 35%, a silver cash shortage would take place. We could be looking at the beginnings of a bank run. The Dow rose 109 in anticipation of the vote in the Greek House on the bailout package. S&P rose 99 and Nasdaq 210 points. The 10-year T-note yielded 2.90%. In the currencies, the yen fell 0.66 cents. The euro rose 1.07 cents. The pound rose 0.09 cents. The Swiss franc rose 0.28 cents. And the Canadian dollar rose 0.19 cents. The USDX fell 0.32 cents. Oil fell 40 cents. Gas rose 3 cents. And natural gas rose 3 cents. Copper fell 3 cents, platinum fell $2.50, and palladium fell $3. The CRB fell 1.14. On Tuesday, spot gold was unchanged as August rose $5. Spot silver rose 50 cents to $33.63, and July rose 25 cents. On the shares, Agnico Eagle Mines fell 3.61% or $2.35 on good news. Silver Standard Resources rose 1.37% or 34 cents. Minefinders rose 2.93% or 36 cents on good news. And Pretium Resources rose 1% or 9 cents. The 5-year Treasury auction was dismal. $35 billion in 5-year debt. The bid was for 2.59 times the offer, the lowest in a year. Foreign central banks bought 37.62%, the lowest in 4 months. The ECB said there was no change in the gold positions of European central banks. CME Group will launch short-term options contracts for gold, crude oil, and natural gas on July the 16th, the exchange operator announced Tuesday. The new short-term crude oil and natural gas options contracts will be listed on the New York Mercantile Exchange, and the short-term gold options will be on the COMEX division of NYMEX. CME Group owns the exchanges. Harriet Hunnable, Managing Director for Metals Products with CME Group, said, quote, "Recent global macroeconomic events and volatility underscore the need for tools to enable market participants to manage their basis risk every day. The new gold options contracts will provide customers with much greater flexibility to manage the risk associated with government economic data, world events, and other market-moving factors, while enabling them to benefit from the lower cost associated with short-dated options," end quote. As was the case with e-micro gold futures launched in the fourth quarter, the short-term gold options will represent, quote, a cost-effective means for professional investors to gain exposure to gold, end quote. The new short-term options contracts will have daily expiration dates listed up to 5 days in advance. Short-term gold options will run off the standard strike prices in the cycle month futures contracts. Meanwhile, short-term natural gas and crude oil options will run off standard strike prices and the standard front month futures contract. The Bank for International Settlements held 409 metric tons of bullion related to gold swap contracts as of March 31st, up 18% from a year earlier. The BIS held 346 tons of gold in connection with swap operations through March 31 last year, the Basel, Switzerland-based bank said in its annual report today. Under swap contracts, the bank exchanges currencies for physical gold, which it must return at the end of the contract. The bank's gold investment assets stood at 109 tons, down from 120 tons a year earlier, it said. Emerging market countries continue to be the most vulnerable to inflation as economic recovery and supply disruptions drive food and commodity prices higher, the BIS said. Advanced economies may be affected by inflation via global supply chains as producers in emerging markets pass on higher labor costs to consumers, the bank said. This is how the central banks depress gold prices when they feel like it. It is within the rules of the IMF to swap gold, say, with the Fed or the US Treasury, eventually receive US dollars in payment, and still carry the gold on their books as if they still owned it. This subterfuge has been going on for years. In other commodities news, the United States and other industrial nations said Thursday that they will release 60 million barrels of crude oil from strategic stockpiles in an effort to reduce the price of fuel and to jolt the stalling economic recovery. The United States will sell 30 million barrels from its Strategic Petroleum Reserve over the next 30 days. The largest release ever from the nation's emergency energy stockpile. The International Energy Agency said its other members will draw down an equal amount. The announcement led to a debate in Congress about the appropriate use of the strategic reserve. Some analysts noted that the drawdown would amount to less than what the world consumes in a single day, and that its effect would be fleeting. In Canadian news, Canadians' confidence in the country's economic prospects fell to its lowest in 2 years, amid concerns that the global recovery is stalling, according to a poll by Nanos Research. The proportion of Canadians who predict a weaker economy in the next 6 months rose to 23.6% from 19.1% in March, according to Nanos's quarterly economic survey. The share of Canadians who see a stronger economic fell to 29.2% from 30.3%. The Nanos Expectations Index, which also includes perceptions related to home prices, fell to 112.8 in the second quarter, the lowest since the second quarter of 2009. The data suggests Canadian consumers may curtail spending as Europe's sovereign debt crisis continues, and evidence mounts that the US economy is slowing, according to Nick Nanos, president of the Ottawa-based polling company. In European news now, the Greek Parliament's vote of confidence in Prime Minister George Papandreou shifts the spotlight back to Germany and the European Central Bank as key to Greece's quest for further international financial aid. Lawmakers in Athens supported Papandreou in a 155-143 vote after the Prime Minister shuffled his cabinet and sought the chamber's approval. The vote may bolster Greece's chances of securing a 12 billion euro loan payment, which hinges on support from European leaders and Greece's ability to push through 78 billion euros in additional budget cuts next week. Ilan Solot, currency strategist at Brown Brothers Harriman in London, said, quote, "The question that's still lingering is the old cage match between the ECB and Germany, and who's going to give and who's going to blink and how much," end quote. The Frankfurt-based central bank and German Chancellor Angela Merkel's government have clashed over the role of private creditors in the Greek rescue, with the ECB resisting Germany's call to require investor participation. European leaders will discuss Greece's need at a two-day summit in Brussels starting tomorrow, and finance chiefs will decide on July the 3rd whether Greece has met conditions for the next aid payment. Investors are watching to see if the Greek ministers will clear the payment, which is contingent on the Greek Parliament approving the extra budget cuts or prolong the uncertainty in a bid to increase pressure on the lawmakers. A full restructuring of Greece's debt would have, quote, "completely uncontrollable," quote, unquote, effects on financial markets and could threaten other countries, Chancellor Angela Merkel of Germany warned yesterday. Reducing the amount of debt to be repaid would endanger banks and other creditors who hold Greek bonds, along with institutions that sold insurance against a default, Merkel said. Those credit default swaps have a significantly higher face value than the debt itself, and the consequences of their being called can't be foreseen, she said. Merkel told Parliament's European Affairs Committee, quote, "Nobody around the globe knows exactly who holds those papers and what it means if they come due." She said it was unclear who will have to pay how much and who will need fresh capital, end quote. A debt restructuring also could prove contagious, leading investors to question the stability of other European nations. The Chancellor wants private creditors to voluntarily contribute to the next aid package for Greece, an initiative for which Merkel does not yet have a majority among leaders of the 27 EU nations holding a summit in Brussels this week. It remains unclear how much money might be contributed by private creditors, but Merkel said it must be substantial. The EU summit comes after Greek Prime Minister George Papandreou survived a vote of no confidence early yesterday, paving the way for an even tougher vote next week on the adoption of a new austerity measures. Europe's leaders prepared the way yesterday for a second large bailout of Greece, pledging not to abandon the nation to a default, providing that its parliament approves a tough package of austerity measures next week. Angela Merkel, the Chancellor of Germany, told reporters at the end of a two-day meeting in Brussels, quote, "We have agreed that there will be a new program for Greece. This is an important decision that says, once again, we will do everything to stabilize the euro overall, end quote. The comments came a day after Greece agreed with international creditors to more austerity measures as part of a revised plan for 2011 to 2015 aimed at plugging a gap in its future financing. If Parliament approves this proposal next week, the European Union and the International Monetary Fund will release a $17 billion tranche of emergency aid and then put together a second rescue. The shape and size of the new bailout could become clear at a meeting on July 3 of Eurozone finance ministers in Brussels. All this comes at a little more than a year after the government in Athens won a package of loans worth $155.9 billion. President Nicolas Sarkozy of France said at a news conference, quote, Greece is supported. Europeans trust the Greek authorities and Parliament in their endeavours to implement the bold measures that have been decided, end quote. After discussions with the Greek Prime Minister, George Papandreou, European leaders expressed confidence that Parliament would approve the austerity package, which has prompted large protests in Athens. Greece's opposition leader insists that his party will vote against the government's latest round of austerity measures, dashing hopes that the nation's political class will unite in a large ditch effort to prevent a sovereign debt default. Greek creditors may be headed toward an agreement to roll over 70% of their bonds into longer maturity debt to prevent a default and meet politicians' calls that they contribute to Greece's second rescue in as many years. French President Nicolas Sarkozy said today at a press conference in Paris, quote, we've been working on this and hope other countries will join the proposal, end quote. Germany's biggest banks and insurers are weighing the French proposal, a person familiar with the matter said today. German and French lenders are the biggest European holders of Greek debt, and their participation in the plan is key to achieving a European Union goal to get banks to roll over at least 30 billion euros of bonds. The rollover is part of a broader aid package that EU leaders have pledged to pass next month to prevent the euro region's first default a year after the 110 billion euro Greek bailout that failed to stop the debt crisis. The market iTrax SOVEX WE gauge of default swaps on 15 governments rose 5.5 basis points to 247.5 after earlier reaching a record, and contracts tied to Greece climbed 23 basis points to 2,138, signalling an 84% probability of default within 5 years, according to CMA. Swaps insuring Irish bonds added 27 basis points to an all-time high, 832, and Portugal increased 21 to a record 859. European banks hold 17.2 billion euros of Greek bonds maturing by the end of 2013, Citigroup estimated in a June 23 report. Greek banks, which will join a rollover, hold almost 22 billion euros of bonds maturing in that period, and the country's central bank owned 5.1 billion euros of the debt likely eligible for the rollover, Citigroup estimated. France's proposal for a 70% participation target came after separate talks last week with German, Dutch, Belgian and French banks on the rollover. German Finance Ministry spokesman Martin Krienbaum told reporters in Berlin today, quote, "The German government welcomes it when proposals come from the private sector, including those on private creditor participation that are now coming out of France," end quote. Talks with German financial institutions are ongoing, he said. Orlando Green, a fixed income strategist at Credit Agricole SA in London, said, quote, "If the private sector is voluntarily getting involved, then that would be seen as a positive because it would help avert a Greek default," end quote. Under the French plan, 50% of the Greek debt held would be rolled over into 30-year bonds. The remaining 20% would go into a special purpose vehicle used to guarantee the 30-year debt, a person familiar with the plan said yesterday. Negotiations shifted to Rome today, where Director General of the Treasury, Vittorio Grilli, hosted representatives of some of the world's biggest banks. Grilli is chairing the meeting in his capacity as the head of the European Union's Economic and Finance Committee, which helps prepare policy for European finance ministers. He is in discussion with a group of bank executives and Charles Dallara, managing director of the Institute of International Finance, which represents more than 400 of the world's biggest financial services companies. The European Commission and the Eurozone were represented at a technical level at the Rome meeting. Commission spokesman Amadeo Alatav said today in Brussels, "The European Central Bank, the biggest holder of Greek debt, was also taking part in the Rome talks, according to a person familiar with the negotiations. Sarkozy insisted that any participation by banks had to be voluntary. Credit rating companies have threatened to rule Greece in default if banks are coerced into rolling over debt, a move that would devastate the country's banking system and possibly drag down other high-debt nations such as Portugal, Ireland and Spain." Sarkozy said, quote, "If it wasn't voluntary, it would be viewed as a default with huge risks of catastrophic results," end quote. Altafaj said, quote, "The European Commission also insisted that there is no coercive element envisioned. We don't want, under any circumstances, there to be any kind of selective default," end quote. European Central Bank President Jean-Claude Trichet said, "Risk signals for financial stability in the euro area are flashing red as the debt crisis threatens to infect banks." Trichet said late yesterday in Frankfurt after a meeting of the European Systemic Risk Board, referring to the group's planned dashboard to monitor risks, quote, "On a personal basis, I would say yes, it is red. The message of the board is that the link between debt problems and banks is the most serious threat to financial stability in the European Union." Trichet, who chairs the ESRB, made the remarks as European leaders meet in Brussels to discuss how to stave off the Greek default while preparing a second bailout. The EU is trying to avoid a repeat of the financial crisis that followed the 2008 collapse of Lehman Brothers Holdings and resulted in European governments setting aside more than $5 trillion to support banks. The yield difference or spread between 10-year German bunds and Greek securities of a similar maturity was at 1,388 basis points today, up from 1,317 at the beginning of the month. Swaps on Greece rose 25 basis points to 2012, signalling an 82% chance of default within 5 years, according to CMA. Before signing off today, we would like to thank all of our subscribers for making these broadcasts happen. None of this would have been possible without your continued valuable support. New listeners are able to promote our videos, but watching these podcasts on YouTube isn't enough. We need you to promote them. These are some ideas. Please rate this video. Follow me on Twitter at Richard J. Wood. Find me on Facebook. Subscribe to our videos. Embed this video on your site. Embed our videos in your blog. Please post your comments. Email our YouTube link to your friends and contacts. Ask people you know to tell their lists and contacts. Write an article about our video and post it to article directories and forums. Post our video to LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, and all your social networks. Ask people to share. When posting on social networks, include, please retweet or share this with your friends. Really helps. Create playlists. Playlists are a great way to get our videos watched by a lot of people. Here's how. Add our video to a new playlist. Add great videos on the same topic from other people. Choose a smart name for the playlist. Think about your keywords. And check out the rest of our channel. Coming up on the program tomorrow, Christine Lagarde was named the first female head of the International Monetary Fund to take on Europe's debt crisis. Deutsche Bank and UniCredit may have to raise additional capital after regulators dismissed lenders' threats that stiffer rules may stunt economic growth. And UK house prices fell for a second month in June as the growth in the supply of properties for sale outpaced demand. Be sure to join us then. I'm Richard Wood, and this has been Zed News. Because you can handle the truth.